Everyone probably wants to talk to you about Game of Thrones or wants to mention anything. We had that little chat outside and
we just
probably got on to about your music that you mentioned earlier.
Mm-hmm.
And we kind of wanted to know a little bit more, like what's your sound or what inspired you to sort of go that direction?
My older sister had a beautiful voice and played guitar, and there was some music in my family, and I always wanted to give it a go. And I remember I was around 10 maybe at my old school, and we had this singing teacher called Aggie, who was crazy, but she was fun, and she made me sing I Dreamed a Dream in a concert, and I didn't think that like anything would happen with it, and then I sung it and I was like, oh, this is actually really fun, like I really like doing this. And from there I just fell in love with it, bought my first piano, taught myself to play, and I've been obsessed with it ever since, really. Yeah.
My brother's a musician, but he's also a policeman, but he never sort of goes out to push himself from the music side of things. He's always sort of like keeping himself downscale. Do you think, obviously, being an actress, being a Game of Thrones, is that something you want to sort of bench off, or do you want to sort of stay away from that and go solely just into music?
No, I would love to be able to carry on as my career with acting and keep music to the side for a while. I definitely keep it on the back burner. It's just something that I love to do, and if I get more successful with acting, then maybe just like slip it out later on in life. But I think my focus is on my acting at the moment. But I'd love to keep it brewing and see if anything good ever happens with it.
So how did you get the Game of Thrones role in the first place?
With the Game of Thrones role, I had just moved to my new agency, which was independent. It was actually the first audition I ever did with them. And my agent just called and said that, look, we've got this really great opportunity for you to do the Game of Thrones audition. Even if nothing happens from it, it's great to meet those people. They're amazing in the industry. And I was like, yeah, wow, I'm going to get to meet people who work with Game of Thrones. It's so great. And I got a call back and I was like, I was so surprised, because I went to the audition in like my school uniform, and there were so many beautiful girls surrounding me with like amazing hair, and I was like in there with my little rucksack with my mum, like, I do not belong here. And obviously I did something right, because they called me back, and straight after the callback, where I met David and Dan and some people in there, and straight after that, a couple of days later, they gave me the call. I was in the park with my best friend. It was very exciting.
Jumping up and down.
Yeah, it was a great moment.
Were you sort of nervous going into such a big franchise, or did you just treat it as just another job?
Well, it was definitely the biggest thing I had ever done ever, and it was quite daunting knowing I was going to have to just at 14, you know, walk in and do it. Because there are so many amazing actors, and it's such an incredible machine, Game of Thrones, that you're sort of expected to be at your best always. And obviously that there was a bit of pressure that came along with that, but it was completely overwhelming excitement, really, that carried me through. And I just crossed my fingers and hoped I didn't fall over in that massive dress.
Following on from that, do you have any special memories from your time on the show?
Special memories from my time on the show. Well, actually, the first scene I ever shot was the scene where Indira kisses me and transfers the poison to me. And we were on this massive, I don't know what it's called, jetty? Something like that. In the water in Split in Croatia. It was my first day, and I was in a really big dress with a really long cape, and I had to step off of the Jesse onto a tiny little boat over some water, and walking in the dress alone was hard, and Nikolai had to help me into the boat in the shot, and I tripped on my dress, and I was that close to going in the water beneath me, and I was like, brilliant first impression, Nell, that's great, I have to swim to the shore to finish the scene. But Nikolai caught me, and it was a nice hello, like, hi, thank you for leaving me. But yeah, that's a really funny memory, I think. Also very embarrassing.
Impressive to do with one hand, that.
Yeah. One hand saved life.
You probably get bored of answering this question, but had you read the books before you went into the show? Were you a fan of the show, or did you just go straight into it?
I hadn't read any of the books, and I had seen a couple episodes. I went on holiday with some friends, and they were obsessed with it, and so we watched a couple episodes on holiday, but my sister and my mum were the real diehard fans of the show. So when I got the audition, they were like, no way. And I was aware as to how incredible the show actually was, but I wasn't a big fan, no, but I mean, everybody I knew was. But yeah.
I was just going to say, what's next for you? What's your next plan?
Well, I've just been in Italy for 6 months filming a feature movie called Wonderwell, which hopefully will be out by the end of the year. So there's that's happening, and I'm off to LA in a couple of days for a sort of working holiday to meet some people out there. And, you know, there's always a couple things in the pipeline. You never really know what's going to happen, just fielding some stuff. And I can't say anything for 100% certain, but things are looking good, hopefully.
Yeah. What would be a dream role for you?
Dream role for me? If I was in a Quentin Tarantino movie, then I could die happy. But I mean, that's dreaming big, right? Yeah. Every character that I've played so far have had really similar qualities. They've all been quite quiet and serene and sweet. And I'd just really like to play a bitch. I'd love to do that, to actually play somebody who's really nasty, like a bad baddie. I'd love to play a bad character, but like also a lovable one, you know. I'd love to do that. But that'd be a massive challenge, which I'd love to take on.
Especially
if it was Tarantino.
Actresses or actors you'd want to work with going forward? Is there anyone, like you said, Tarantino, is there anything like in particular with his like usual cast that he has?
Yeah. It's always been a massive dream of mine to work with Tom Hanks. I think he is just the most phenomenal actor ever. I love him. And Meryl Streep is my idol completely. So Tom Hanks, Meryl Streep, Tarantino, I'm ready, let's do it.
That would be
incredible. Wouldn't that be the dream team? And then just like me in the corner. But I would love to do that. And Leonardo DiCaprio, for obvious reasons.
I think we're all just stuck imagining that movie now.
Yeah, the best.
That would be mad. You mentioned Meryl Streep.
Yes.
Is she kind of the person that made you want to go into acting, or was it just always been there?
In all honesty, with acting, it was a complete fluke how I ended up in the business. It was a just complete accident. It wasn't ever the plan. But I've always loved movies and things like that. And every film I've ever seen her in, I adored her. And if I were to ever be able to be half as credible and talented as her, then I would die happy. So she is my acting hero, and I aspire to be like her. But she's definitely the type of person who, when you watch her perform, you're like, I would love to be able to do something like that. And to create something like that people can just, like, you know, at the end of Kramer versus Kramer, when she's like, he is home and everybody's crying. It's like, I wouldn't make somebody cry like that, but like, in a good way, in a cool way. But yeah.
Quote, you'd like to make someone cry.
You literally just written that down.
Did you? Oh no, you make me sound really mean.
I want to
play a baddie and make people cry, apparently.
What's like your usual daily life? Like, obviously, you know, it must have been a bit of change when you went into that, and obviously going forward, you know, you want to do the acting, and that's obviously, I mean, you have to make that every day sort of thing.
What was the best was that I was in Seville for 3 weeks filming Game of Thrones. Mm. Pretending to be an adult every day and going to set and, you know, trying to feel that crazy world. And then 3 days later, I was in my maths class in Teddington, you know, revising for my GCSEs. So that was my favourite part of it, really, because it's like living a double life, you know, going on set and being this person and being a princess for a couple of weeks and then being in detention the week after. So I think that was probably my favourite part of it, and that was my day-to-day life at school. But I've left school now, so I'm just, you know, pondering along. Yeah, but I mean, I'm doing a lot of meetings and things like that, and just trying to pretend to be an adult, really. But my mum still does my washing and probably will till the day I die. But I'm just trying.
I think most adults are still pretending to be.
Yeah.
Did it make it hard going back to school after 3 weeks in Seville being a princess?
I got a couple of Game of Thrones jokes on the daily, even from the teachers as well. Once I brought coffee into the library and the librarian was like, you may be a princess on TV, but in here you're just a school kid. I was like, oh really, are you serious? Come on. But yeah, actually he said I was a queen. I was like, actually I was a princess, but like whatever. And so things like that did make it a little bit difficult. And you know, you're always going to get that handful of people who just want to kick you because you're trying to do something and doing okay at it. And obviously that was hard and kids can be mean, but adapting to it in myself and being just falling back into my friends and back into work wasn't too difficult for me because I had a tutor on set and stuff. So, I mean, yeah, it wasn't completely foreign when I got back, but what was most difficult was, you know, trying to sort out the people who only like to a little bit more now because you just come back from filming, or people who actually just wanted to be your friend. So that was difficult, but you live and you learn. I mean, that happened to me so badly when I was 12 and I did my first ever movie, and then you came back and everybody looks at you and talks to you like you're an alien. So that was difficult, but I think I've learned to spot them now, which is a good skill to have, especially in this business.
Yeah. Cool. You have a really amazing attitude to it. The fact that you can just go in.
You.
And, no, I think I have lots of admiration for that. I think
that's really good. Thanks. Well, you know, sort of, I got it from my mum. My mum's a great teacher as to how to just always keep a level head and, you know, thank the Lord every day that you're so lucky to be where you are. And I guess I'm just always grateful. Like, even sitting here now, I'm just so blown away that you guys actually want to talk to me.
did you tell us you were coming here for this sort of event? Is this your first time?
This is my first time ever, as you can probably tell. A lot of nervous laughing. But
was the advice just sort of like, be yourself, or, you know, do normal?
No, my mum wouldn't advise me to be myself because she knows how annoying I can be. Don't be yourself, but like a little bit less annoying. No. My mum was just like, look, have fun and make sure you're always nice, say your please and thank yous, and yeah, just be yourself but less annoying. She loves me.
Yeah,
she's great, I promise. But she was proud that I'm here, and you know, also she just laughs all the time. She just finds it so funny, like, wait, people actually want to talk to you, like, people are going to pay you money to sign a picture of yourself. So funny. She's just thinks,
right,
it's hilarious.
My mum says that to me anyway, like, people just want to talk to you.
Yeah.
You're my mum.
Yeah, no, she's very funny.
Yeah. So is this your first Comic Con completely?
This is my first one.
Have you been enjoying it?
It's great. Have you seen some of the costumes?
I know, they're
incredible. Amazing, aren't they? I saw my favourites. I saw Prince Eric and Ariel downstairs. You go, guys.
Joffrey.
Represent. Huh?
You're not seeing Joffrey.
I've seen a couple Joffreys knocking around. It's like, yeah. Yeah. But yeah, no, I've loved it. It's a completely different world. Like, I was not expecting it to be anything of this scale, of this magnitude whatsoever. Completely blown away by it, but in a really good way. I just think it's amazing.
Someone asked earlier to one of the other actors about, like, they do it just to come to things like this, and obviously that's not really the case for a big young actors, but like, for yourself being younger, do you feel like, actually, like, yeah, no, I can do that as well. That's a lot of fun. Like you said, do you ever feel like maybe next year you'll come in costume?
Come in costume?
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think I'm quite ready. I don't think I'm quite ready for the costume, maybe. But I feel like if I dressed up as me, as like Marcella, everyone else was in normal clothes and I was just at the table like, by the way, I'm, you know, this is me. Like, I probably wouldn't look too good. Maybe if I came as like a minion in like the minion suit, or like a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle or something, that would be awesome. But yeah, maybe just to come and dress up with my friends would be hilarious. But
yeah.
But I'm not even good at Halloween, like, so yeah, seriously. But that's why, like, the commitment that some people put into this is just like insane. It is so cool.
Half the fun is making the costume, so.
Yeah, I can imagine. I can imagine. Literally, I've just been sitting at my little desk, like, watching everybody, like, this is so cool. Somebody was in, like, full green body paint and just, like, a bra and knickers. I was like, okay, you go, girl. You do you. Yeah. I think she was the Hulk. I'm not sure, but it would look great.
So you've done Game of Thrones. If you had the opportunity to do any other TV show, past, present or future, what show would it be?
Friends. 100%. I want to be one of the friends. I would love to have done Friends. Also, I would have really loved to have been in Gossip Girl. I don't know if any of you have seen it, but it's amazing. And it was like the, you know, XOXO, Gossip Girl. I would have loved to have been able to do something like that. But yeah, definitely Friends, which would have been great. Yeah.
You said you're going to LA to do a sort of working holiday. How's your American accent?
In the movie, I just did. I was American.
Oh, okay. Actually.
So it's pretty good. I mean, some of my family are from LA, so Valley girl, you know, totally. But it's quite, I think it's all right. I get by. Sometimes if I've lost my train ticket, I just pretend to be American. I'm like, I'm really lost. I don't know where I am. Please, could you just let me on the train? And then that's actually true. Yeah, it does.
You do realise we put these videos online. You do realise
Southwest train service, like, I'm actually American.
It's the British accent.
This
that's
is the British accent cover up.
It's not happening again.
Yeah, they're going to be like, it's you. We know your English.
I think I used religion to get me through church. I was like, God bless you. And she was like, yeah, you can go through. Don't you? I think it's actually easy. Don't worry about it. Just go on through. You don't have to pay.
Just hope for the best. Running behind someone else. Actually, don't do that.
You may have done that this morning. My ticket wasn't working. I have a ticket. It just wasn't working.
You've got to do what you've got to do to get in sometimes. Did you try the accent trick?
Only accent I can do is Russian. Really badly.
That could work too.
Well, that could quite scare people.
I feel like people wouldn't question it. Like, you just do it and they'll be like, okay, we'll just let her through. Just let her through.
Now we've got to the point of pleasant conversation.
Yeah. I think we've got off track.
Yeah, it's
now far too pleasant to be a person. So I think unless anyone has any final questions, I think we should probably call it then. Yeah. If that's cool.
It's good.
Thank you.
Cheers. Thank you.
Thank you.
Before
thank
I
you.
Ticket.